What's up guys, Genesis King here, and in today's video, I'll be providing you with a quick guide for cruiser ship design in Stellaris. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing down below for more Stellaris tips, videos, live streams, and let's plays. With that, let's dive on in. Okay, so the first design that you are going to want to do as soon as you unlock the cruiser blueprints slash in the mid-game is going to be this design here with the broadside bow, broadside core, and gunship stern. So as you can see, it gives us two medium slots, three medium slots, and then two small slots for our weapons up here. And this is because, assuming that you are either leading technologically wise in the game, or you are at a minimum keeping up with the other empires, this will be the biggest ship on the field, and you want to make sure that you still have the higher tracking on the medium and small weapons, the 50% and 30% respectively, because you still will be targeting a lot of corvettes and destroyers, and you want to make sure that your tracking is able to target them with this larger ship size. And down here on your defenses, again, balance just for this, but you always want to try to counter what your enemy is doing. Similarly up here, weapons. Here, as you can see, I am running two afterburners in the A slots down here. And this is because when you do get your cruisers built, as you go through the larger ship sizes, they will be slower than your destroyers and your corvettes. And for me, sublight speed is a huge part of my strategy, so I like to do this just so that the entire fleet as a whole is not slowed down as much by these cruisers. So this next design is going to be a carrier version of the cruiser. So if you have a fondness for Strikecraft, and I definitely do, this is the design for you. I wouldn't suggest building this design until you have at least the first level of basic Strikecraft unlocked. I don't usually run this until I get to there. The scout wings are great for anti-missile defense, but I don't see the benefit for running those, so just wait until you get the basic Strikecraft. In addition to the hangar core, it's got this point defense here, which will help out your fleet against missiles and other Strikecraft. And for whatever reason, I usually like to run the missile bow in addition to my hangar core, but you can mix or match this depending on what your preferences for weapons are, keeping in mind what ships you will be facing, as I mentioned on the previous ship design. Generally speaking, I like to go with swarmer missiles in the mid game, and as I get down here, I do like to switch over to devastator torpedoes as I move into the later game. And the next designs, well, designs plural, that we have are going to be a couple of late game designs. So anti-large ship designs, one which is against shields, and one that is against armor. So this first armor, if we come in here and fill in our shield, this first one is anti-armor. So as we can see up here, we are running artillery bow, artillery core, and a broadside stern. So that gives us two large weapon slots and two medium. When I get neutron launchers, I definitely like to use these when I am going anti-armor. As you can see, there's a plus 50% armor damage bonus, as well as a plus 75 damage bonus to go along with it. And the even nicer thing about this is it is going to have a range of 130, so it can get these off prior to engaging with smaller ships or other cruisers or battleships that may or may not be able to take it out. In addition to the neutron launchers, I do like to run the large plasma cannons. Again, as you can see, this has a plus 100% armor damage bonus, and then another plus 50% damage to the hull. On this design, you want to make sure that if we click in to the combat computer, that you are running the line computer. Reason being, it sits at a range of 50, and unfortunately, these plasma cannons only have a range of 60. Even if you were to jump up, say, to the artillery that has the plus 20% range bonus, that still would not get this 60 up to the 80 that this ship would sit at. So you want to make sure that you are running the line combat computer. And moving on to the anti-shield version, Here you can see we are running kinetic artillery for our large weapons. Once again, a plus 100% shield damage. And look at that range, 120. In addition to that, I like to run the Gauss cannons in the medium slot, which has a range of 75 and a plus 50% shield damage. On this design, you can run the artillery because that plus 20% ship range weapons boost will get the Gauss cannon up above that 80 range that the ship will sit at. On these, because it is a large ship killer, I go with a couple of auxiliary fire controls for the plus 5 chance to hit on each of those, so that there's a better chance that your weapons will impact the larger ships. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more Stellaris content. Let me know what cruiser designs you use down below in the comments, and I will talk to you guys in the next video. Later, everybody.